Hi everyone, I'm super excited today. We're gonna have a new LEGO Friends set and we get a new mini doll. This is the LEGO Friends Dolphin Rescue Mission and it looks awesome. We're going to have so many cool underwater adventures with this set and we get new coral pieces. That's super cool. Here you see where the ship wheel is hiding a treasure and there are more secret hiding spots. And we get a lovely dolphin. And look at this. Oh, we get a baby dolphin. That's super cute. Now let's open it up. Let's start with the underwater adventure. So this set has three bags with a lot of new pieces, these nice rescue stickers, and two instruction books. But first, have yourself a super click party.
Subscribe.
Give this channel a subscribe, press the thumbs up button, and leave a comment down below to answer the question of the day. Who is your favorite character? And we start with the first mini doll. It's the bad girl, it's Casey. She's wearing this dark blue diving suit. And actually, this time around, we get the hair pieces with it. So we get the hair pieces and the diving helmets. That's really cool. And we see these minty patterns on the sides of the diving suit. And like I said, we get the diving helmet for the girls. We have this nice dark blue one for Casey with some goggles and the snorkel so that she can enjoy all the beauty of the underwater world. And next we have Stephanie. And we give her a nice light blue and magenta diving suit. And we give her some green fins to move easily and quickly on the water when she's competing against Casey with a treasure hunt. And of course for her rescue missions. And of course a diving helmet is a very important accessory. Again with these goggles and the snorkel. And actually a very nice detail of this helmet is that Stephanie's hair is attached to it. So that looks really a lot better than that that helmet would be just a loose helmet. I like it a lot. So right after that was done, I actually suddenly realized that I mistakenly swapped the faces. So the eye colors of Stephanie should be the bright blue ones instead of the very subtle blue with green ones of Casey. And another difference is the little smile versus the bigger smile and the thin and thicker eyebrows. But in all fairness, I was really too excited when I was building and the differences at that point were really too subtle for me. So now here we are fixing it. And you get a good view how it actually needs to be. And otherwise, we just say that they were face swapping in Snapchat. Well, let's continue with the treasure chest. And we're gonna fill this up with some beautiful gemstones. We also have a few in the shape of a heart. And we go on with the next accessory build. It's going to be an underwater scooter. But this time it's a very special one, especially designed for heavy lifting on the water. So that's very convenient when you're on a treasure hunt. It has this big propeller on the back. And a nice sticker in the same colors as Casey's diving suit. And we put on some handlebars to hold, to actually control the underwater scooter and even its robotic arms. And the robotic arms, those we are building right here. You can put them underneath. And of course, Casey wants to give it a try. Oh, one moment, there goes your fin. Well, off she goes exploring. And when this would be the real treasure hunt, that would be way too easy. But she may do this now, it's just for demonstration purposes. But as you can see, the whole system works perfectly. Ken those fins. Now let's get on to the first scene. A little underwater scenery with a big rock on the bottom of the ocean. We see some seaweed on the side. And I really love these new coral pieces. Really amazing pieces, really cool. Can you imagine that you're actually making like a whole underwater landscape with it? It would be amazing. And we have this crate laying here on the bottom of the ocean. Probably it floated away from the shipwreck. But it forms a perfect spot for some secret items to hide or to find. Like this piece of textile, for example, which we can roll up and we can put it in here. But wait, that actually looks like a secret map of a pirate. Let's see what happens if we put it underwater. Look! A secret treasure map appears. Oh, that's awesome. Well, let's roll it up and hide it in here so that the girls can find it later. And we also have a glass bottle so that you, when you are stranded somewhere, you actually can send a message to someone for help. Well, if anybody finds the bottle with the letter inside. Now we start with the build of the amazing submarine for Stephanie to help all the underwater life. Really such a unique idea of the LEGO Friends designers. With the LEGO City we go to the moon, with LEGO Friends we explore the ocean. Really super cool. And I don't know if you already actually saw it, but LEGO themselves, they put a video on their YouTube channel where you can see and hear about the inspiration of this set. And also actually you can see the real life submarine that this set is based on. So I will put a link in the description for you when you want to see. But of course do that later on after that you watch this video. And we have these big tanks underneath. And this submarine also gets two robotic arms. Of course those are a lot more powerful than the ones underneath the water scooter. And we can click them up front. Well, it already looks cool, right? It's like a stingray. And we attach a hook to the robotic arm for easily attachments. And we attach the bottom of the submarine. It has a smooth round shape to it so that it can glide easily through the water. And we will create a cockpit in here and an animal rescue, treating and transport area. And totally up front we have the seat for Stephanie to sit in and actually have like a magnificent view underwater. With the control handles right here next to her, she can control the throttle and also the movement of the arms. And we have a bar to rest against. Stephanie jumps right into it in her full diving gear, even with the fins. Well, let's continue with the back of the submarine and also the transport compartment. And here in the back we have these bars. And this construction is actually to connect the propeller engines to later on. Now first let's give this sub some more characteristic shapes. And here in this transport treatment compartment we find a syringe, also a bottle of milk. So it actually also can be like a little nursery area maybe. And we have a glass panel between the cockpit and the transport area. And to be able to see something deep underwater where the sunlight doesn't come, we need some big flashlights. And those we can hang underneath the sub. And the cockpit will have like an all-around panoramic view. So that's awesome. And now on the back we have these huge opening doors. They even have like big windows in the shape of a heart on both sides. So the animals that are inside will feel less locked up when we are trying to help them. And up front there is a little placeholder where you put your feet. I've also put a little heart sign, and that's actually the same heart sign that we also saw at Turtle Beach Rescue Clinic. Stephanie is all driven to go and explore. And we give it these rescue signs at the sides. And some roof pieces. We put an iconic dome in place that should be like really a super amazing view. Look how cool Stephanie looks in that cockpit. That's really awesome. Now let's build propeller engines, otherwise it's not going so far. So what's also special with this kind of system is that the stand of the engines actually controls the movement of the submarine, going up and down, left and right. And here we have a back fin for probably some stabilizing more likely. And again, these heart rescue signs. And the submarine gets a periscope to have a view around the submarine and also above the water without being noticeable. And Stephanie goes on her exploration, the first try tour. And what does she see over there? A lovely dolphin! Well, that's a very curious dolphin, even tapping the glass. Oh, whoa, it points Stephanie directly to the treasure. Now, I don't know when we're actually gonna need them, but I found this little baggie with a lot of super cute small animals, probably to create some sea life activity. But look at all these cuties, they are so adorable. We have an octopus, some shells, and a cute coral fish. And sea snails. And a bigger shell. Oh, and sea stars. Oh, whoa, this is so cool. Look, we have seahorses. Oh, I didn't expect seahorses. That's really cool. But wait for it, there's even one more surprise. Look at this. Oh my god. There's baby turtles, they were already super adorable. But look at this baby dolphin. Oh my god. Oh, so super cute. Alright, now we get to the biggest exploration site. This was gonna be very awesome. So we have this this ocean area over here, and we first gonna create some rock formations. And this is actually where the ship stranded. I put some seaweed over here, and we also create some hiding spots for the animals. And here we see the first part of the shipwreck. And there is a fishy swimming and a shell on the rock. And we can see the belly of the ship. And here we create a nice hiding spot. And another small one on the other side. And you see the rocks came right through the belly of the ship. So we put these wooden planks on the sides. And there are gonna be some attachment points. And there is an anchor, probably still holding the wreck in place. Some more seaweed. And here we are creating the front of the ship. That's very cool how to get the shape. And we're also gonna put the awesome new coral pieces onto it. So even the coral started already growing on the shipwreck. That's awesome. And this is also a perfect spot for an octopus. Now, let's create the back of the ship. It still has a fin on the back of the ship, still attached. And there is a secret compartment underneath the bridge where the captain normally would stand onto, where also the steering wheel is placed. And also here we have some coral started to grow onto it. Now more seaweed on the other side. And here we have the steering wheel. And we connect a pedal to it to hang underneath in the secret compartment with a sea star onto it. And as you now turn the wheel, the pedal can push the treasure outside of the secret compartment. Now let's connect everything together. So now we create the mast, the long pole, where the sails normally are attached to. And actually, there's still some leftovers from the sails. and there is a ring attached to the mast with another sea star onto it. And here we have a flag for the top of the mast. And again, another awesome play function. And here is the hiding spot for the cute baby dolphin. And we have a little red ball for it to play with. And some more sea life activity is going on. A little sea house finds himself a nice spot. And the coral fishy feels right at home. And we actually have a few more to put around. Well, let's make it a seahorse gathering. And here is a sail on top of the coral. So here we have the baby dolphin, and the red playing ball actually is all the way out of its shelter. Oh no! The mast fell over! The baby dolphin is trapped! Quick, Stephanie, we need your help! There she goes! And we can connect and grab the ring with the hook of the submarine and slowly get it back up. Yes, we freed the baby dolphin! And Mama Dolphin quickly comes to check on if everything is alright. Well, what a super original and beautiful set. It was really a pure joy to build it and explore all these things down the way. And also all these super small cute animals. Really love them. Yes, truly an amazing set. Tons of play functionality. I hope you enjoyed it as much as I did. When you want to see more videos, then please subscribe. Thank you for watching. Till next time. Bye-bye.